Okay, so there's the shark, and it not only swims, as you just saw, but it also flies, flicker style. Here goes. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I used a 6-inch square of kami. And that's what I'm going to teach it to you from, because in order for it to fly well, it really needs to be from a 6-inch square. Although you could try from a sheet of printer paper cut square, but then you won't have this eye on it. And this model is really just good from one side. Okay, let's get started. Let's begin colored side up, and let's valley fold diagonally in half. Try to make really exact folds and crease sharply. I always say that. And now let's unfold and rotate, and let's fold in half in this direction. So we're starting from a water bomb base. So let's fold this corner to here. And turn over, and let's fold this corner to here. And let's open the big pocket, put your finger all the way to the bottom, and let's bring these two points together, so flatten it. And here we have the water bomb base. Okay, let's rotate it, and let's fold this edge to this edge. And when you do that, really press down with your index fingers so that the paper doesn't slide. Okay, and let's crease sharply and unfold. And let's do the same thing on this side. Let's fold this edge to this edge. And once again, press down and make the fold. And let's unfold. Okay, now we're going to make a rabbit ear. So let's pinch right along this crease. And now let's fold on these two creases. Like this. And let's flatten it up. And flatten it down. And let's bring it up and put your finger right in the middle slot, and we're going to squash it. So just kind of press down on this fold and try to squash it evenly. So this edge is going to land on this crease and this edge will land on this crease when it's flattened. Like this. Okay, let's rotate. And let's fold this corner to this point. And unfold. And now let's fold this edge to the crease. Okay, and rotate. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And let's turn over. And now we're going to reach in here and pull out all the raw edges. So we just pull out four layers and we leave two. So it's like that, and now just press down here, so we're squashing it like this. So this crease should land on this crease, like that. From the other side, let's turn it over, that's what it should look like. Now let's fold this rhombus in half. So just fold the flap up. Like that. By the way, this is my little boo-boo. I caught a club while I was juggling, but I didn't catch it right and it ended up cutting me on my knuckle. So that's my juggling boo-boo. Okay, now let's pull this flap up like this, and we're going to reverse fold it, just this layer, and we want to just pull it up, and the object is we want it to stick out of this edge so that it's symmetrical with this flap. So just kind of adjust it until it looks the same, like that. Okay, let's turn it over. This is the dorsal fin. So here's the tail fin. This is gonna be the top fin. Let's hold it right here and open right here and just squeeze the very tip like that from the top. You wanna squeeze it so that it's a rhombus. So just kind of squeeze it down like that. Okay? And now let's squash it down like that. I didn't really do too well, but I actually did really well because this is round. You can just kind of shape it to taste. I like it like that. Okay, now let's work on the lower fin. So this is going to be a little bit shorter. Let's fold this corner to right here. And now let's open this little pocket. I'm going to use this pointer device. So open it up like that and just squash it evenly down. Like that. Hello. Okay. Now let's fold this quadrilateral in half. Like that. Okay, now let's fold this little flap over like that, as far as it will go, and unfold, and let's open this pocket right here and just stick it into the pocket. You might need to use the pointer device. Yeah, mine's kind of bent there. I'm gonna push it in with the pencil. Okay, that's better. All right, so here we have the tail. Whew. Okay, now let's turn over left to right and let's reach in and let's pull this layer down and flatten. And now let's fold this edge to this crease. And rotate. And let's fold this flap up. We want this edge to align with this edge, and let's fold it up right to this crease. And crease it sharply. And now let's unfold, and let's refold the flap so that this crease right here aligns with this edge. So it's like this. Okay, now let's wrap this flap over this edge, like this. And let's turn it over. And if we did that right, this edge should be parallel with this crease. Okay, now let's fold this flap down so that the fold line aligns with the crease. You can actually go about a millimeter further down. That'll make your fin a little bit larger. Okay, so it's like that. And now let's bring this edge behind, and you see the paper just kind of slides. So bring it down like this from the back side. This is what it should look like. Okay, now let's put a finger right in like that, and let's squash it down so that this edge is parallel with this edge. So it's about like that. Okay, and let's fold this edge right here behind as far as it will go. Just melt and fold it. Like that. Okay, now let's fold this corner down about like that. And let's fold this tippy flap up right over the edge. Easier said than done. Okay, there it is, microscopic flap. Okay, now let's unfold the itsy bitsy flap and try to open up this little pocket right here. And you might want to use the pointer device, otherwise known as the pencil. And now that you have the black hole open, let's stick the itsy bitsy flap into the black hole and close the hole. Okay, and there we have the flap. If you want, you can kind of narrow the flap a little bit by folding this edge behind just a tiny bit. That'll help keep the flap down when it flies. That looks pretty good. But let's round it off. Just round it to taste. All these little rounds make it a little bit more aerodynamic, I suppose. Okay, so there's the flap. Okay, let's rotate and let's fold this corner to this point. And just put a little crease mark right on this corner and unfold. And now let's fold this point to your crease mark. And unfold and bring the corner to this crease mark. And guess what we're gonna do? We are going to squash this flap. But I don't know about you, but my fingers won't go in there. Oh, actually it opened. It worked. If it hadn't worked, what I was going to do is open up this flap like this, and now it's easier to flatten. But another way to do it would be to use your pointer device. Okay. So here we have the microscopic squash that will become the eye. Let's put a little fingernail mark right on the diagonal. And that way it'll be really easy to fold the raw corner over. Okay, there it is. And there is the eye of the shark. It's a little bit too far forward. So, this is what we're going to do. Let's turn over and let's rotate. And let's fold this flap up like this. So this edge is perpendicular to this edge. And this edge runs right into the eye. So about like that. And now let's fold the eye flap behind. Like that. And when we turn it over, the eye is in a pretty good spot. You might want to bring it a little bit further forward and up like that. That way the nose isn't quite as sharp and the eye is in a slightly better spot. Okay, now let's work on the mouth. So for the mouth, we're going to just put a little indent right here. So it's about like that. This is to taste. Oop, I closed the eye. It's a sleepy shark. Okay. And if you want, you can make a little mountain fold that goes from this point over to about here. Just a tiny little fold. I'm using my fingernails to just suggest a mouth. So it's like that. Are you guys sleepy yet? The shark is. Wake up! Okay, there we go. All right, let's work on the dorsal fin. So turn over and let's fold this edge to the crease. And let's fold this flap inside as far as it goes. Actually, we're folding the flap so that it's parallel with this edge. Like that. Okay, let's turn back over and let's make some gills. So we're going to make a mountain fold right from this point, and it goes up, not all the way, but about like that. And if you want, you can try to do that on the table so it's really sharp. And a great white shark has 5 gills, or at least that's what the picture indicates. So let's make 4 more. And this one can also originate at this point and just angle it slightly. And crease it. And number 3, this one can just be a millimeter away. And 4. And 5. I don't know, that's to taste. I think the gills are a little bit too close to the mouth, but oh well. All right, now let's fold this whole tail over like this, and be careful, try not to rip this corner. It'll probably rip anyway, but just do your best to fold it gently. And now let's make a fold that goes from this point, right from the end of this crease, and it slants about like that. So there it is. And that way the tail is just a little bit more even. It has a little bit of curvature. Well, it will when we curve it. Okay, now let's fold this point behind. And this is really where it often rips. So let's just do your best. Hold it in your hand and just squeeze the point so that it doesn't absorb the shock of the fold as much. Just fold it over like that. And yes, it ripped, but that's the weakness of origami rather than the weakness of the design. Okay. There it is. And we're pretty much done. This guy keeps on wanting to go to sleep. But let's go around just rounding the edges. So let's fold the dorsal fin behind. That way we can make a nice round curve all the way along the back. Like that. And I'm going to show you from the other side. So, yeah, this side does not look pretty, but that's the nature of this model. Try to make the fold go all the way to the tail. And you can squash it, flatten it as good as you can. We want it to really be flat, that way it'll be aerodynamic and it'll fly well. Okay, and let's fold the flap back up. Somehow this got unfolded, so I'm gonna refold it. Okay, and just fold it. Back up like that and turn back over. And just try to make the dorsal fin look nice and be flat. That's the object. Use your strength. Ugh. Okay. So if you like it like that, then you're done. But I'm gonna put a little bit more curving, shaping. Just fold that edge behind. And I'm gonna try to put a little curvature on the back of the fin. Okay. The top is pretty good. Now let's shape the tail. So I think just shaping the bottom part of the tail is good enough. There, and let's try to take this little point and fold it behind, or sink it, however you can round it. Okay. And let's fold this corner behind. We're now on the underside of the shark. Okay, so that's pretty good, but you just really want it to be flat in order for it to flick well. So press it against the table and just do your best to get it to be flat. All of the flaps need to be flat against the table. And you can test yourself by looking at it from the edge. Like here, I see this flap sticking up. So just flatten it there. The tail looks pretty good. And the head, just kind of twist it a little bit. And that looks pretty flat. But if you want, you can just kind of push it up. Give it a little bit of curvature so that on the front side it's a little bit convex, and that will act as an airfoil and will give the shark some lift when it's flying through the air, kind of like an airplane wing. Okay, so there it is, and from the back side, which doesn't look so good, but the front side makes up for it. So there it is. And now I'm going to show you how to flick it. All right, so how to flick this thing. Well, first, please understand that it's very difficult to flick and get it to fly well. It took me many tries because you have all of these flaps here, and if they're not perfectly aligned, then it's not gonna fly very well. But hopefully with practice and determination, you'll be able to get it. And I'm gonna help you right now. So to flick it, you wanna make sure that you have all of the flaps on a plane. And you can test that out by just holding it like this and making sure that it's a line like that. Even if like this flap is sticking up, that's gonna totally ruin the flight. So you wanna make sure that all of the appendages are perfectly flat like that. And when you have them as flat as you can, then it's time to flick. And this is how to do it. Let's rotate. And I think it's best to flick right on this edge right here, the bottom edge of the tail, and hold it like this loosely in your left hand, right about at the fin. And you're going to tilt it to the left. If you want it to fly far, tilt it to the left and hit it so that your finger is perpendicular to this edge. And you just want to try to make it spin as much as possible. Just imagine that it's spinning. Here it goes. As I was saying, it's very difficult for me. So let's try it again. Okay, just like this. And just try to move this finger, nothing else. And there it goes. Oh my gosh, it hit Mr. Brazil. Sorry about that, but that was pretty cool. Okay, how to get it to boomerang. So basically it's the same thing, but you want to tilt it upwards. So you just hold it like this and try to hit it near this line right here. Near this line right here. Here it goes. There you have it. So as you can see, it's very difficult to flick, but with enough practice, you'll get it. And if you run out of patience and can't, well, at least you have the shark that looks like this. Well, I hope you guys have fun with this model, and I'll see you later. Oh, yeah! And if you flick it upward, it can even boomerang. And if you flick it upward, it can even boomerang. Or not. Fail. Epic fail. Oh, yeah!